Thursday evening to everybody. Hope everybody is having a good week so far. I wonder if this is not loud enough. It is what it is. Hopefully it's okay. It should be. So look at this beautiful Kodiak. So, we are going to do this aviation without all borders. I don't want to use the English version name of it because I can't. I'll just butcher the French. It's custom content. There's 4 missions. I don't know how many of these we'll be able to fit in today. But we're going to fly those. We're going to listen to the instructions because I had a quick sneak peek at it earlier. And there are some instructions. It's going to tell us exactly what we're going to need to do or expect it to do. And we'll go from there, see how it goes. I'm sitting in a different chair than usual, and it's weird. It's gonna take some adjusting. All right. I don't like
we're
how
flying
it's already...
with Aviation song Frontières, Aviation Without Borders. Starting here in Bangui, Central African Republic, we're embarking upon a medical rescue trip to Mobai. En route, we're stopping by Alinda O to deliver a supply of vaccines and medical supplies for 50 children. Then it's direct to Mobai to collect a patient that was injured during some extreme weather nearby, which is still ongoing. To help navigation, enter Foxtrot Echo Foxtrot Alpha as your direct to waypoint in the G1000. To do this, click the Direct To button at the bottom right of the PFD and use the FMS knob underneath to set FE-FA. This enters a GPS route to Lindau and allows the autopilot to guide you.
Alright, FE-FA. Ooh, did she say lightning strike? God. The Lindau. Activate. There, I think that's all they're going to give us at this point. I think we will get some other instructions later. Make sure we're on the local barometer, which we are. Really low pressure, 9 or 9 or 8. But, we have... Okay, so yes, we actually have passengers, and we have cargo. And I love how it's actually modeled, like, the textures include the Aviation Without Borders logo and everything. So it's really well done. There's a custom co-pilot. Hello, sir. Good to go. Okay. Click close check. I just want to make sure everything's turned on here. I guess it should be. Generators are on. We have got our taxi lights. Taxi lights. on the strobes. Really won't be there yet. Landing lights will come. Edo heat. Okay, it looks like we're just gonna take off on whichever runway that is. So, park brake, a little bit of throttle, we'll go out to lightning. This feels very weird in this chair. I used to sit on a DX Racer chair, which I reviewed a lot for a different website, and I have sacrificed it for a racing cockpit I'm building for sim racing. So I'm sitting in my regular desk chair, which is actually a very nice comfort chair. It's actually arguably more comfortable than the desk chair. But it also means that I'm not used to sitting on this chair while flying. It's a little bit lower, I think. I may need to actually see if I can raise it. I don't know if it's lower. It's a bigger chair. It's actually a more comfortable chair, but it feels different. I'm so used to squeezing my butt into the DX Racer. But it is what it is, and it works. Now as we get onto the runway, we turn on landing lights and strobes. Taxi lights on. We'll turn to the right here, and we'll turn around at the end of the runway. This is by the book. I don't know what to expect from the mission. I believe there is an actual small scenario. So we are flying to Lindau with medical supplies, vaccines, essentially, and I guess a doctor. As you can see, the weather is not great. I don't think we were told any kind of cruise altitude. To be honest, I'm not even sure what airport we're coming at, so we're going to have to pick one. What are we at? 1,200 feet elevation here. That weather does not look great. Lots of cloud cover. We'll play it by ear. Put in 5,000 feet here. We'll see if that leaves us below the clouds, hopefully. Or above it. We want to stay below the clouds, I think. Which may be difficult to do. That lightning strike looked like it did inside the cockpit. It did, but it sure looked like it. Tanks are both there. How much fuel do we have? We have lots of fuel. What else do I need to check? Because I didn't start this aircraft up, it's already running for me. Air conditioning is on. 21 degrees set. I want it nice and cool. I'm okay with that. I don't think we have to worry about any icing. It's 36 degrees outside. Unless we get a little too high, which I don't plan on getting. I suspect we're going to be flying a lot of this visually, because we just have a direct marker across 165 miles. So we'll see. We'll get the flight directors on. We'll get the goddamn armed on. I will arm GPS mode. And then when we climb, we'll climb at about 100 knots. Flaps are set. We've got a very long runway, so that should not be a problem. We have a tail under here? What are we doing here? We have Juliet Hilo ready for departure runway, whatever number. What is this? 60. Alright, away we go. Engine damage. climb, gear up. Nope, just kidding. No gear up. This way. Alright. Good. Another knots to 5,000. We'll see how close that gets us to the clouds. I'm not quite sure of what to expect between us here. So. But this plane is all quiet. Looks like we're taking off from a Foxtrot and Fox, which is Bangu Mpoko International Airport. Flying to Lindau Airport. It's pretty. Back there. Orbx looks secured. He looks excited. He's got that 1,000-yard stare. Does he have anything different in his uniform? Maybe. That might be the A from Aviation Without Borders. Alright, 5,000 looks like a decent altitude. Keeps us below clouds, at least for now. There's plenty of rain ahead of us there. Love that. The moon is full of the clouds. Great. Cruise will dial the RPM down to 5,000. improvement, not really. It looks like it's getting worse ahead of us. So, yeah. Looks very bad to our right. It looks a little bit less terrible on our left. I feel like we should try to... Like, if we kind of follow this river, like there's rain over there, but at least it doesn't look completely pitch black yet. I don't know if we're supposed to be taking initiative on these missions or just follow the GPS, but I want to try to avoid that thunderstorm ahead of us there, so that does not look good. There's thunder over there too. It's just not quite as dark. We're aiming for that bit of sunshine there ahead of us. Trying to follow the light. I'm thinking right through there. And avoid that nastiness on the right, because that just looks awful. It's not looking great on the left. The river seems pretty rained in. It's brightest looking over there, I think. That also means we can kind of parallel our GPS track. We'll give it a try anyway and see how that goes. Seems like the engine noise has been very quiet on the inside of the Kodiak. I don't know if it's always been like that. But I don't start kicking my heel against it. Okay, a little bit of opening in the sky. Not much, but I feel like it's raining all around us, but not right where we are. Which, I mean, I'm okay with that. She looks sunnier over there where our original GPS track was, so let's cut across here while the weather's good. I don't see any comfort. I was just looking at the propeller lever and I was like, why is that not all the way forward? And then I remembered we're aiming for 2000 RPM. on the GPS track. We're right in the midst of the bad weather. We'll just kind of see if we can make it here. This, what I'm gonna do now here is something that I don't think you can do without the NXI mod for the G1000. I'm going to try to see if I can set us up an approach. We are going 09 is the easiest one to get in. The wind here right now is coming the other way, though, to be honest. No idea what the wind is at a Lindau, though, so we'll go with 09 visual. And it's going to draw us a nice line. Do vectors. Don't care about minimums. Obstacle clearance not provided. Yep, that's fine. Ooh.
Great, now complete any checks and turn left to taxi to the halting point.
Oh, weird. It thinks we landed. Ha! Huh. That's interesting. What did it do with this line? It's done some really weird stuff with our, That is bizarre. Well, we're still 80 miles away from the final approach fix, which is fine. Should be at 1780 there. So what happened to our flight plan? I wonder if it's because we have no origin in here. Well, whatever. That's fine. We've got this on the map. We're just going to fly heading. As you can see, it's pretty much taking us directly where we want to go. Thought we were going to do something cool here with this mod, but it just kind of confused the mission. bless you. That most definitely struck inside the cockpit. Start setting up for our landing here. I think this gives us some indication of the runway altitude. No. I guess it does not. Well, the final approach was 1780. Probably assume that the runway is another 1,000 below that or so. So. Make me not work from here. It does give us a top of descent pretty close to that, so we're still 40 miles away. We had it right for the top of descent at least. actually have the GPS line back. I think it should intercept the GPS track here, if we do that right. And we can hop on over to that and actually get ourselves a nice straight-in visual approach. Well, visual is a bit of a... I mean, it's actually not too bad, to be honest. There are bright spots in between. Hopefully there's some lights at the airfield, but probably not. My money is on not. Also don't feel like that top of descent is early enough, so let's try to get ahead of the ball a little bit here. Full. Unless that marker is just wrong, because the light slope indicator, or rather the V-path indicator there, is coming a lot closer than, a lot faster than the TOD on the map. Either way, it's just going to catch it. We're going to intercept the heading, the GPS track here in a second. And at some point we'll catch the V-path. I love a good working Garmin GPS. The NXI mod is really good. You really need to have it. Can't wait to see what Working Title does with the G3000, which is in some of my favorite planes, which renders them really useless. Still there, this guy hasn't blinked the whole flight. Let's start to slow down. I think I see an airstrip straight ahead there. Wow. up so we can go 138, 120, and 108. Oh wow, we're getting low. Here's definitely a bit higher, so maybe the, yeah, the top of descent was pretty accurate then, actually. Alright. First notch of flaps here. Can't fly the rest of this. There's two. It's so bouncy. That is a sandy runway. Hello, Squires. What a top boy. Thanks for the biddies. It's a bit too slow. Distracted me with shiny things in the chat. Okay, let's not. Last time I landed this plane somewhere, I came up a bit short. I don't want to do that here. This flight is to Lindau. It's in Central Africa. We've got doctors and medicine as our cargo. This is the actual missions. So, all right. Here we are. Pretty good. That's a bit rough. It's in reverse. There's the ambulance that's probably waiting for us. I don't know where they said they wanted us to taxi to. I don't know if there was anywhere in particular. Let me just check the documentation. Just to make sure we are completing this successfully correctly. So this is the humanitarian wings, and there is a user guide. I'm not on this one, there is on this one. Annoying. Okay. Well, we've made it here. I don't know if we're supposed to park anywhere in particular. Maybe we'll taxi over to the ambulance. I don't actually know if it's supposed to mark anything as complete or not, or if this is just, you know, we just park it and turn it off. I'm not that familiar with like bush trips in the sim. I actually want to do more of them. They're like the actual content based stuff. There's nothing over there, really, is there, that we should be taking the airplane to? No. Alright, I think we're good here. We're gonna shut her down here anyway.
for your work. Like they needed to put a quick spot somewhere today.
Okay, I guess we'll just go and start up the next one. Assuming the next one is going to be on again. So this was under activities, and this is actually custom content. And I don't think it says that it's whether or not it completes. You just have to do one after the other. So we're going to continue. See, this is weird, though. I feel like something broke. It says continue the trip after yesterday's setbacks to deliver the vaccines. Well, we didn't have a setback. We made it there. Something didn't go right. I don't know if we missed a radio message by being outside. Yeah, because it looks like they wanted us to divert. And we never did that. I guess I got to stay in the cabin to hear radio messages. Which, quite frankly, is a little bit stupid. So we missed whatever radio call telling us to divert to a different airport because of the weather. Which is what I was expecting based on the description, and then it just never happened. Or at least I never heard it. So if I didn't hear it, it didn't happen. All right, we're in Kawango. Fox Echo Golf Kilo.
Good morning. Yesterday didn't go quite to plan, but things are clearing up now. There was more severe weather yesterday at Linda O. Hold tight. We're just waiting to hear how the conditions are at the moment. Okay, they say that the weather has mostly cleared away, but the runway is very wet. It's another unpaved runway, so we'll have to be careful to check it out before we land. Set Alinda O, Foxtrot Echo, Foxtrot Alpha as the direct to waypoint. Great, take off when you're ready. Watch for any vehicles on the runway.
See then? I mean, the runway was nice and dry yesterday, but where do I know? I just flew there by accident. Alright, how far away are we? 73 miles. Okie dokie. Well, we'll go back to 5,000. That served us pretty well last time. Director Yaw-Damper now. And I think this looks like we are sitting right at the edge of the runway. Yes, we are. So we can basically we'll taxi out a little bit here. You're going right away. Oops. Flaps are set. Flaps are set. Here. Oh, man, why are we turning that much to the right? It's gonna be nice, actually. We're taking off right into the sunrise. See, that I do like. I guess I just can't go outside the cabin for very long. A bit bouncy on the takeoff there, but we're good. We're gonna fly right. Oh, this is a river. River, right? Yeah. Followed that river for a bit earlier.
The route takes us slightly to the left. Intercept and follow the GPS route to Ilindao. Keep us climbing up and we'll descend on a cruising altitude based on the cloud.
This should be sunrise because we're flying due east. He's talking a lot more. He's talking a lot more about what we need to do. I feel like something got missed on the first, on day one, because, yeah, I felt a little left alone. I thought there was going to be more talking.
The cloud is a little lower today. Climb to cruise altitude of 5,000 feet to keep us underneath.
Look at that. See, we never got any instructions as to cruise altitude on the first leg. Something a little wonky on that first one. Or maybe I literally just missed it a couple times. It's weird. And I think when we overflew this airport, it told me to taxi, so it triggered based on that. It was just a bit weird. It's probably my fault, but whatever. We know how to make this landing. We've done it once now. That was just a practice run. We'll probably have to do, we're going to have to do the next few days next week. I wonder if I'm going to have to redo day one, if it's going to mark this as complete or not, or if there's such a thing as marking it as complete, I'm not sure. If there is, I'm going to have to redo the first one. Which is not a big deal, actually. I really like flying the Kodiak. It's such a good plane. And I can't wait. They're coming out with a amphibious version, so Flotiac, probably in the next few weeks. And I'm excited to fly that on stream. So we're gonna do some of Bill's bush trips in Montana, I think, or Wyoming.
Maintain 5,000 feet.
Cruise
altitude.
Never told us any
on the
of that
GPS
stuff
route.
In the first one.
There are some showers en route, but nothing that looks like it needs avoiding so far.
Somehow it never triggered us over to the next setting. Because I think when I tuned in the destination, I'm going to have to try this again right after this. Because on this one, when I put in Fox Echo Fox Alpha as the destination, he said great, and then continued to give us some instructions. That never happened on the first day. It's quite the view, though. Right there is where I want it. 2,000 RPM, 600 degrees in the ITT, more or less.
Weather up ahead doesn't look too bad today, except a few showers. We'll check the runway at Alinda O with a low pass before landing. If it's too muddy, we won't be able to land. For now, stick to the GPS route at 5,000 feet.
Yeah, 100%, something never got triggered, because I did the whole flight previously for like an hour, and he didn't say a peep. Something was wrong there. Oh well, I'll do that one again. Off stream. take a chance to work inside. I feel like it was bugged on the first one. I feel like we should still hear his messages even if we're outside the cockpit. I mean, people want to enjoy the scenery. How would they not be outside the cockpit if there's no?
Alright, 20 nautical miles to go. When we make our low pass, we'll be able to see if the runway is usable. Badalite is a little way to the south of our current position. It's south of the border, but has a paved runway. Let's hope that the runway at Olindo isn't flooded or bogged after yesterday's storm. Start descending to 3,000 feet, the height at which we'll make our
I love
pass.
That. I really wish we would have had this before last time. Like, because this is actually what makes this content a little bit more interesting. Just like, here's a start and an end point, and yeah, you're taking medicine. This is a bit more story driven, if you will. Which is what I was expecting, so I was a little confused by that first day. I'll have to try again and see if there was something wrong, or if I did something wrong. This is as much more like it. Sent to 3000, we'll check the runway. Hopefully, it's not too wet.
Level off at 3,000 feet. Alinda O's elevation is about 1,500 feet, so this is a good height for our flight past.
I remember to get out of the plane as soon as he starts talking next time so that I can confirm that I can still hear him outside the cockpit. Okay, I think we can actually see a bit of the room right now.
think about.
5 miles to go. See the winding river up ahead? Yep. The airfield is just on the other side of the river. We're pretty much already lined up with the runway. Fly overhead along the length of runway 09, and all being well, we'll turn around to land on runway 27.
Okay.
I forgot to get out of the cockpit again. God damn.
It does look pretty wet down there, but seems good enough for us to use. Great, get set up for a visual approach to runway 27 at Alindao. Come to a full stop on the runway. Remember,
the kind of
it will be muddy, so it will be slippery and take longer to stop.
Visual 27, vectors. See if we can swing this puppy around. There's enough. On a custom-made throttle handle that's just like the one in this plane with those little silver textured things there. It's so cool to use. I highly recommend that if you do flights and you throw a lot of money at the hardware because it's a lot of fun. Just do it. The runway. come to a full stop on the runway, he said. Bumpy and we got tailwind. We really should have landed the other way. Trees on this side of the runway, which is not ideal. Oh, we clipped a little bit of those trees there. Lost layers.
Nice job. It's a bit muddier here than it looked from the air, so I think we can expect to stay the night until it dries out.
Aha! See, there we go. My best score is no score. I guess it doesn't score this. Yeah, 0, 0. Okay, so back to main menu. Nice. Okay, well, that's pretty much gonna... I'm just gonna have another real quick look at the start of that first leg to see if I can figure out if I did something wrong or missed something or what. Because I want to see if there's a chance for me to redo that. Cause otherwise, I don't care. It doesn't actually show up anywhere. It doesn't show... there's no score. Nothing to actually really worry about. But that's kind of what I was expecting. Some little summary at the end of the flight.
Flying with Aviation sans Frontières, Aviation without Borders. Starting here in Bangui, Central African Republic, we're embarking upon a medical rescue trip to Mobai. En route, we're stopping by Alinda O to deliver a supply of vaccines and medical supplies for 50 children. Then it's direct to Mobai to collect a patient that was injured during some extreme weather nearby, which is still ongoing. To help navigation, enter Foxtrot Echo Foxtrot Alpha as your direct to waypoint in the G1000. To do this, click the direct to button at the bottom right of the PFD and use the FMS knob underneath to set FEFA. This enters a GPS route to Lindau and allows the autopilot to guide you. Great, now complete any checks and turn left to taxi to the holding point.
I wonder if we skipped the holding point and it never triggered because we... I bet you that's exactly what happened. Let's try this real quick. Taxi left to the holding point. Should just be. Maybe it's just because I didn't stop at the holding point. The holding point should be up here just before the runway.
Looks clear both ways. Taxi onto the runway and turn left. We're going to backtrack to the end.
I don't actually remember if I heard him say that. It's also possible that, because I went to the other air, the other end of the runway, so he might have said this and I completely missed it. Went to the wrong side. Got 8 minutes here to try to see if I can take off and. At least that way I'll probably refly this tomorrow, because I'm kind of curious to see how that divergent motor turned out.
Text from Melinda O, warning us that the severe weather is picking up again and that there is a storm approaching the airport. We best get there quickly before it gets any worse.
We missed out on all of this. Oh, what a bummer. Okay, I'll just do it again.
That's far enough. Turn around here and line up on the center line.
We're going to be doing lots of small bush trips on future streams, because I think they're kind of neat little content.
All right, we're all set. Take off from runway 34 when you're ready, climbing steeply after departure.
Just climbing steeply. No word of how high we want to go. All right.
Make a right turn onto our GPS track. It'll take us the shortest route towards Olindo.
Yeah, we screwed that up. I think I went to the wrong runway in the beginning, and then it doesn't fix itself. It doesn't realize that. It just waits for me to show up at the runway where it never showed up, of course. So, okay, well.
Good, now intercept and follow the GPS route. That's the magenta bar on your PFD.
Big old Tib, thanks for the follow. Got me just at the very end here. But the good news is, I will be back next Thursday night, and we're going to be continuing these bush trips in the Central African Republic for Aviation Without Borders. Should be a fun flight. Now that I know to listen for the instructions. Otherwise, get lost.
Okay, we're on our way. Maintain the GPS route and keep climbing. You can offload the navigation to the autopilot by using nav mode if you prefer.
Alright, beautiful stuff. Well, as I said, we will continue this next week.
The weather does seem to be a little worse along our route. We'll get an update soon to see how things look further ahead. Let's cruise at 7,000 feet to stay below the layer of cloud so that we can see any en route weather. For now, follow the GPS route to Alindao.
Yes, we'll continue this next week. Thanks so much for watching. If you haven't checked out Shack Pets in particular, watch this trailer. Visit shackpets.com. It's a wonderful free app for Apple and Android. And of course, visit shacknews.com for more updates on future streams. And of course, all the gaming news, guides, interviews, long read features, everything your gaming heart could desire. I will catch you all next week. Have a wonderful time. See you later. Ha ha!